Hello everyone and welcome back. So in the previous video we were talking about auth controller, auth services and user service. So if we just target what we are going to cover is, so we are not going to have a user module. Okay. So we are just going to have a user service, and we already have a auth module which is having auth service and auth controller. Okay, so this auth controller will talk to user service. Okay, so what is the flow? So we in the auth controller, we are going to have a login or register route. Okay, and then this controller will talk to user service. We will inject user service here, and user service will validate, okay, user already exists, can you register a new user, same email ID already exists or not, or user login credentials are valid or not. Okay, so it is talking to a TV model, which is user model. Okay, then what this auth service is doing? Auth service is helping us to validate token or generate token once you are actually validating a user. If user is logged in, if user credentials are valid, then we are generating a token. We are validating the expiry. You can call it as a validating token or generating token or all the other things related to the token, GWT. So for all these things we are using GWT, JSON Web Token, this module, and we are using passport to manage the session of user, and passport GWT, and actually Next.js also provide Next.js passport. So we have already installed all these modules. What we need is Next.js passport, passport GWT, passport and passport GWT. Okay, we'll see what all modules we are using. First of all, this is the layout. Okay, auth controller and auth services will be doing only validation. They don't have any dependency on database, so we are not going to inject the Mongoose schema model in the auth service. Only the user service, which is in the shared module, and we don't have a user controller, right? So there is no point of creating a user module which is going to have a user service, user controller and all. We can just create a user service. User service will be a part of shared module, and we will import it in the main module. So main module we are importing shared module and auth module. Auth module is the main primary thing which is going to have all those things. Auth module has a dependency on shared module also. So now if you understand how the dependency works, so auth module, auth service is depending on the user service, right? But how you can access the user service in auth module, you have to declare explicit dependency. Okay, auth module is dependent on the shared module which you are putting in the imports. Okay, then we have auth controller. Auth controller has two things, login and register, these two routes. And for validation we have a DTOs. First we are doing a validation. Okay, find by login if user exists. So find by login is a method which is actually validating the username and password. We have already written this method in the user service. It is actually validating either based on username or email, does user exist. Then it is comparing the password. If all good, then it is sanitizing, removing the user from the data and returning that user to auth service. Okay, here we have auth controller, and once auth service dot sign payload, now you got the data from auth service. So this auth controller is having two dependency. One is auth service, one is a user service. Auth service is generating token, user service is validating that user already exists in system with a valid credential or not. Okay, find by login, we create a payload. So to create a token, we have to construct a payload so that when user is coming back after login, we should be able to validate the token, validate the payload, and that payload can be used to manage the user session in Node.js. Okay, authorize.sign payload, and we are generating this. So simple login. What all it dependent on? User service and auth service. Auth service, what auth service is doing? If you just see this, auth service is doing sign payload and validate. Sign payload is nothing but it is doing a JWT.sign method, and here we are passing the payload and secret key which we have in the .env file. You can see secret key we are passing in the .env file. secret key and expires 12 hours expiry we have given to this token. And validate is user is nothing but find by payload. So in the user service, once user is coming back and logging in, right, then find by payload, and here from the payload we are getting the username and we are just checking, does this user exist in the system who is coming back after getting the token. Okay, so that we will be doing from the interceptor. So you log in, you get the token, you store the token in the local storage, you are coming back with some other request like, okay, get user information, delete a user or update user. Then we have to validate a user already exists or not, right? So for that particular case, here we have to write one layer. So this is a request coming in, right? So we have to write a GW2 strategy, or you can call it as a middleware. In general language, we were calling it as a middleware in the express. Here we are validating the token. And does this user exist in system? Even if token is valid and that data is already deleted, the user doesn't exist in system, then allow API access, right? This is what we are going to do. So first we request will come, we will write a JWT strategy. From the header we will get authorization token. So this is like this, you log in, you will get a token. Okay, now you are making another request, okay, like get user. So you will send, these are the HTTP headers, I mean this is very traditional way of validating. In the HTTP headers you will send authorization. Okay, now at the server side, in the GWT strategy or middleware, we will capture this authorization, like if your token something like this bearer, and token, then you will just split this based on the space and get the first index from the array. And here you will gwt.verify, you will pass the token and you will pass the same secret key based on which you have actually built this token. If it is true, that means allow user. Okay, you can do additional checks. Okay, once this, because gwt.verify will give you the payload. From the payload you can check that user exists in system from this payload or not. Okay, so in the next video we'll write a GWT strategy. So till this video we created a user service and auth service. Okay.